It takes about a week to get over the sadness and go, oh my God, what am I going to do? But then you just got to sort of dust yourself off and try and think outside the square and just try as many things as possible. Basically, I'm a cheap drag queen. No makeup, no wigs. And I just decorate the jackets and, you know, I get paid the same in the corporate world. So that's good. And it's quicker to get ready. It only takes me 15 minutes.
Welcome to This Way Out, the international LGBT radio magazine. I'm Lucia Chappelle. Sheltering in place is not going to dim the lights of an Australian tradition. This Way Out Sydney correspondent William Broom found out how an LGBTIQ activist entertainer is reimagining the event and taking it global.
And I'd sing, I'd do anything just to get my name in lights. I gotta try to hit the heights now that I'm free as a breeze again, oh nimble knees again.
Hi, James Breko Brechney, welcome to This Way Out.
Hi, William, thanks for having me.
It's great to have you on the show. For people who are outside Sydney, how would you best sum up Vivid Sydney?
Well, it's just an incredible, incredible festival of, you know, of art and light and projections in Sydney. You know, it's really become an annual event that's quite massive here. And it's just gorgeous. And the beautiful thing with the festival, it's a two-week festival. So you can go to the Opera House, you can go to the Harbour Bridge, you can go and see all the buildings that are lit up, and you can go over sort of 2 weeks. And it's just a beautiful time to see the city of Sydney just lit up beautifully. And a mix of art, a mix of very, you know, very just popular projections and things that make people happy. So it's a brilliant festival. It's really sad it's not happening this year.
It's very sad, but you have made the most of it and you've adapted.
DIY Vivid is a concept I sort of came up with my mate Ben a couple of weeks ago to sort of keep the Sydney Vivid Festival spirit alive in this sort of COVID-19 isolation period where people can make their own sort of Vivid happen from home. Now, our concept is like, get those Christmas lights on your balcony, create your own little art installation with lights and bubbles and things, and share the photos online.
And it's a great way to get the community involved, isn't it?
We've had such a great response. Over 1,000 people are going to the event on Facebook. We have like over 4,000 people interested. You got to try and do some happy things during this period, don't you?
Absolutely. And it's about involving the community and including people and putting smiles on their faces.
Yeah, I hope so. Especially in the inner cities where you're overlooking other people's apartments, how hilarious it will be on the 22nd of May when hopefully quite a few apartments are all lit up. It'll feel like Christmas.
It's going to be amazing. It'll be Christmas again. And right now, that's exactly what we need, I think.
Yeah, we've had the Today Show over here at my house, and we've had Channel 7 as well. And it initially just went off bananas on Facebook. So we're really looking forward to it coming. We're actually going to have it a little bit earlier in April, but we've pushed it now to the same time as Sydney Vivid in May. Because when we first started, I wasn't really sure how long we were all going to be at home, Will. But now it looks like we're going to be at home for some time.
It certainly looks like it. I don't think I'll be going anywhere for a while.
We're basically kicking it off on Friday, the 22nd of May, and then we're hoping to keep it going for 2 weeks so people can start getting involved once it launches as well. But anyone that's listening and wants to get involved, no matter where you are in the world, love you to get your Christmas lights out and share a little bit of light and love for your neighbours, you know.
And what's the best way that people can find out about this? Is there a Facebook page?
There is a Facebook page. And I think the easiest way to access that is to go to diyvivid.com.au. And that just links straight through to the event.
Now, you yourself are very resourceful. You're great at coming up with initiatives and ideas. And you're very much part of the LGBTIQ community here in Sydney in Australia. You're a professional gay and we love you for it. We remember you at the marriage equality rallies.
I got engaged at the marriage equality rally and I got married at Mardi Gras. I was on the board of Mardi Gras. I do Mardi Gras floats every year. But my bread and butter, Will, has been trivia nights, four or five nights a week.
So how are you coping? What are you doing? amazing.
Well, it was really tough at first. My residency, you know, I'm at the Imperial Hotel on Mondays, usually, amongst other clubs. And it was just really sad it all having to be put on hold and cancelled for now. But luckily, I've started doing an online trivia on Tuesday nights and an online music bingo on Thursdays. And I'm taking a lot of, doing a lot of work groups, a lot of corporate bookings for work team trivia, like your Friday night drinks or your Thursday night drinks. And I've actually got quite a bit of work, so I've been so blessed and so lucky. It's been really, really awesome. And in fact, I'm going to do a little bit of trivia, I think, a bit of an exclusive for you, that Equality Australia are going to do a queer love-in, and there's going to be a whole bunch of local artists performing. And in amongst the performances, I'm going to do some trivia questions for everybody as well. So
fantastic.
So lovely seeing everyone try to help each other out with leads and everything, and everyone in the community trying to support everybody else, particularly performers and artists who've finding it really tough right now.
And you're doing trivia nights, I think, on Thursday evenings, aren't you?
I do my live Facebook music bingo on Thursday nights. So that is, we DJ the tracks, and that's free to play. And everyone can sign up on my website at jamesbreko.com.au, and we shoot through music bingo cards. And as I DJ the tracks, you just stamp them off, and then we give prizes away. Some pubs have donated some prizes, and we buy some as well. And it's free to play, but we ask for donations, and that's been doing really, really well. Hey, everybody, and welcome to Music Bingo on this lovely Thursday evening. All you have to do as I DJ the tracks is stamp the songs off your card. The first person to get 5 songs left to write, SMS the number on the screen, and we're going to give you a prize. Let's have a good night tonight, everyone. Let's do it. And on Tuesday night, I do a private trivia for people. So you just book in advance, and it's $10 a head. And I get about 50 people a week playing the trivia. So it's really super nice.
That's brilliant. And it's so good that you're sort of involving the community.
Yeah, I mean, I give some advice to some people out there if they're doing it tough, because I think performers and artists were sort of the first ones in the Australian economy to lose all their work. Mm. It takes about a week to get over the sadness and go, oh my God, what am I going to do? But then you just got to sort of dust yourself off and try and think outside the square and just try as many things as possible. And there's no income in DIY Vivid, but it was just a fabulous idea. And it got a little bit of press, and it's just so fun spreading the happiness to everyone. You know what I mean? And that becomes infectious in terms of what else I'm doing as well. That got me a lot of trivia bookings too. So you've just got to try a few things and try and keep your head together.
Now, a little bit more about you. You mentioned you were a member of the Mardi Gras board. I talked about you being at marriage equality rallies. But of course, way back, going quite a few years back, you were very much involved with a rainbow chalking, weren't you?
Yeah, that's probably my first claim to fame, which was just an absolute dream. And this was when the state government tore up the rainbow crossing on Oxford Street. As a joke, Will, and, you know, not intending it to be too crazy, I chalked a rainbow behind my terrace in Surrey Hills. And then all of a sudden it became a bit of a movement, and everyone started chalking rainbows all across Sydney, all across Australia, and then the world. I had Thailand and Russia and Indonesia and heaps in America, and Facebook flew me over to the States, and I got to chalk a rainbow at the Facebook headquarters there in 2014, 2015. And so that was a whirlwind. And I was always a bit of a radio host and a bit of a performer before that, but that was my first sort of delve into activism, and it was a dream come true. It was so much fun, and that's really where I became a lot more heavily linked with the community and doing LGBTQI sort of activism work.
I've got to ask you, those jackets of yours, your trademark bright jackets, how did they come about?
I was always known in my local area for wearing a gold sequins jacket. And then slowly but surely, not only did my body weight increase a little bit, but so did the things that I used to stick on the jackets. So now I've got lots of pom-poms is what I tend to stick on the shoulders. And I always get the spelling wrong, Will, but I think they're called epaulettes or whatever the soldiers wear, or, you know, Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Heart Cross Band. And then you love to get creative. It's basically I'm a cheap drag queen, no makeup, no wigs. And I just decorate the jackets, and, you know, I get paid the same in the corporate world. So that's good. And it's cheaper and it's quicker to get ready. It only takes me 15 minutes. I'm lazy.
So back to DIY Vivid. How successful do you expect it will be?
I've got some people working on it with me now, actually, and they're going to do big bunch of press releases leading up to it and a whole bunch of things, which is awesome. For me, I think it's going to be fabulous, even if it's small or even if it's massive. So it's like growing a plant, Will. You've got to give it the soil, the sun and the water. You've got to give it the best chance to grow and you see what happens. But at the moment, like I said, we've got about 4,000 people involved on the event wall. So I think it's definitely going to be at least a really fun night in 2 weeks. And hopefully it gets a little bit viral and, you know, we see all of Australia light themselves up. That would be, you know, absolutely incredible.
We love you, James Breko Brechney, your fixture of the Sydney community. Thanks so much for talking to us.
Thanks for having me, William. Have a great one.
This is William Broom in Sydney, Australia for This Way Out.
I'll sit on a flagpole, whatever the rage, just to get my picture on the front page, just to get my name.